Let us solve one problem by using moment distribution method. So we have seen various definitions, various theorems in moment distribution, used in moment distribution theorem, moment distribution method, that is carryover theorem, how to calculate stiffness of a member, then distribution theorem, how to calculate the distribution factor. Now by using all this, and also we have seen a list of formulas for fixed end moments, how to calculate the fixed end moment, because that is one of the steps while solving the problems by using moment distribution method. Now consider a problem that continuous beam ABCD, continuous beam ABCD subjected to loads as shown in figure, or loaded and supported as shown in figure. So A is fixed, B is fixed, and B and C are continuous support. B and C are continuous support. So moment of inertia is I, 2I, again I. So we have given, taken different moment of inertia also. So actually in moment distribution method, as compared to slope deflection method, is very simple and very accurate. No doubt it gives approximate, but very, very close to the exact results, acceptable results. And here, generally, slope deflection method, you need a lot of practice for calculation work. Then only you will arrive at the correct answers. However, in moment distribution, at the end of problem, you will come to know whether your answers are correct or not. That means, there are very less chances of making mistakes in moment distribution method. So that's why this method is most favorite or preferred even by the structural consultants in practice. Now, see, it's in my opinion, it's only three-step problem. First, find out fixed end moments by using standard formulas. Second, distribution factors. And third, prepare moment distribution table. And that's the end. So in the table, at the end of table, automatically you will get the final moments. So once you know the moments, then you construct a bending moment diagram. If you want to construct shear force diagram also, so knowing the end moments by using equilibrium conditions, you find out shear forces, that is reactions of the beam, and then you construct shear force diagram also. But here, only BMD I will construct. So SFD you want, you can construct on your own, because you know how to construct shear force diagram. So what is the first step? It's only calculations for fixed end moments. Calculations for fixed end moments. So standard formulas for these fixed end moments are given to you. Now each and every span of the beam is assumed as a fixed. AB you assume as a separate fixed beam and calculate fixed end moments. So AB carries a central concentrated loop, and therefore the MFAB, use this convention, designation, MFAB. M stands for moment, F fixed, A means at end A, AB for beam AB. So fixed end moment at A for AB is equal to left end anticlockwise or downward loading minus WL by 8, because this is a central load. So this is equal to minus W is 12, L is 4 divided by 8. So this comes out to be minus 6 kilonewton meter. Similarly, you find out MFBA. So for the same member but right end. At end B, MFBA. MFBA. So just reverse, you read reverse. This is plus, because loading is symmetrical, so same moment you will get. So this is plus 6 kilonewton meter. So for first span AB, we have calculated fixed end moment. Second span BC, now for span BC, MFBC equal to minus WL square by 12, this is UDL. So minus W is 3, L square, 6 square divided by 12, and this is 9, minus 9 kilonewton meter. Then MFCB equal to plus WL square by 12. So this will be plus 9 kilonewton meter. Then last span MFCD. So we have calculated fixed end moments for AB and BC. Now CD, MFCD, left end minus W A B square by L square, and this is minus W is 10, A is 2, and this is 3 square upon pi U square, L square, and this comes out to be 7.2 minus, you just check it out, 7.2 kilonewton meter. Then the last MFDC, this is plus W S square B, because clockwise, divided by L square, equal to, this is 10 into 2 square 3 divided by 5 square, and this is 4.8 kilonewton meter. So first step is over. Only 3-step problem, remember, it's only 3-step problem. So MFDC. Now next, second step is distribution factors. Now these distribution factors are to be calculated at the joint where the number of members connected are 2 or more than 2. So if we take A, only one member we have, AB, so no distribution factor is required, or only one. Now B, we have BA and BC, so we have to calculate distribution factor at joint B. C, we have CB and CD, again we have to calculate distribution factors at C. Means at joint B and C we have to calculate. So let's consider joint B. Now KBA indicates distribution factor at B towards A. So KBA, stiffness of BA. So further end A is fixed. (4EI/L). Let's substitute the values. 4EI upon L is 4 divided by total stiffness. Only two members are there. 4EI by L plus, again, BC. C is a continuous. For continuous support also, continuous end also, 4EI by L. So this is again 4A, value of I is 2I, divided by L is 6. Value of I is 2i and L is 6. So you find out this. So this is KBC. So only two members are there, and we know that the total is 1 minus So this is 1 divided by I will directly write down, this is 0.43, check it. So this comes out 0.43. Now 1 minus KBA. So 1 minus 0.43 equal to 0.57. Because we know total sum of distribution factor at the joint is 1, only two members are there. Otherwise, this way also you can calculate. This stiffness of BC, that is 4E into bracket 2I divided by 6 divided by total stiffness. That way also you will get the same answer. But once you know this, the last you calculate just by using that total stiffness is 1. The next, let's consider joint C. For joint C, KCB towards B. B is again continuous. So this is 4E 2I divided by 6, L is 6, divided by total stiffness, 4E 2I divided by 6, plus, again D is fixed, 4EI divided by L is 5. And this is 0.62. This is 0.62. So KCD at C again, but towards D, this is 1 minus 0.62 equal to 0.38. Equal to 0.38. So these two steps are very, very simple. These two steps are very, very simple. So you can calculate fixed end moments by using standard formulas, then distribution factors at the joint where the number of members two or more than two. So all this we have done by assuming each span independent with fixed end. But in real beam, the B and C are continuous. They are not fixed. We have assumed the fixed supports and then we have calculated this. Now they are not fixed but they are continuous. Now how to distribute the unbalanced moments at the joint, that we have to see. Now for that we have to prepare one moment distribution table. So what you have to do, you have to understand this moment distribution table properly, then the moment distribution method will be very, very simple. Then you will understand each and every type of problem. So just see the moment the moment distribution table is also of length of beam. Say this, you take vertical line under support A, under support B, under support C, and under support D. So this table is to be prepared. Now we have calculated distribution factors here. Over joint B, we have calculated distribution factors over joint C. So this is A, this is B, this support, the joint is C, and this is D. So we have calculated distribution factors over the, and you enter this value of distribution factor here is 0.43. Now next step is enter the calculated values of distribution factors and fixed end moments at their appropriate places. So now this is 0.43, this side it is 0.57. So KBA is to be entered here towards A, KBC towards C should be written. Then 0.62 KCB and 0.38 KCD, total is 1. So we have entered the distribution factors at their appropriate places. Now let's enter the fixed end moments that we have calculated. So within span AB, so at A, this is anticlockwise minus 6. At B, this is plus 6, right? Similarly, this is minus 9, this is plus 9, then this is minus 7.2, and this is plus 4.8. This fixed end moments we have calculated and we have entered at their appropriate places, right? Now next, see, if you look at the joint B and C, we know that we have used joint equilibrium equation in slope deflection equation that MBA plus MBC must be equal to 0. Means MBA and MBC must be equivalent opposite, right? But what's happening here, this is plus 6 and this is minus 6. They are not equivalent opposite. Means the joint B, even joint C also, this is plus 9, this is minus 7.2. Means joint B and C are not in equilibrium. They are not in equilibrium. Because resultant moment at B must be 0, resultant moment at C must be 0. They are not in equilibrium. Now, we have to make the joints B and C in equilibrium by distribution of moments. And these moments are distributed by using the distribution factors. Now, just first you just try to understand joint B, what is the unbalanced moment? So we have plus 6 minus 9, so this is called unbalanced moment. Unbalanced moment is equal to minus 3. So therefore, balanced moment is equal to plus 3. Means to we have to balance that joint. To balance the joint means we have to apply equal and opposite. If unbalanced is minus, then to balance the joint we have to apply plus 3 externally. So we have to apply plus 3. So means this balanced moment multi, now once we apply this plus 3 at the joint to make it balanced, we have to distribute this moment among the connecting members by using the distribution factors. That is, this plus 3 multiplied by 0.43, you write here, and that comes out to be 1.29. This should be plus, remember, 1.29. So this plus 3 multiplied by 0.43, so plus 1.29. And this side, plus 3 multiplied by 0.57, 1.71. This is also positive. Both this should be positive, remember. So every time the plus sign I will not write, only if it is negative, then only I will write. So plus 1.29. So this 3 multiplied by 0.43, right here. 3 multiplied by 0.57, you write here. So only a calculator is required, nothing is required. So you just calculator, multiplication, addition, that's all. So only table we have to prepare. Now similarly, what is unbalanced? Find out unbalanced moment here. Unbalanced is plus 9 minus 7.2, unbalanced will be positive. What is balanced? Opposite, negative. That means that balanced moment multiplied by 0.62 right here, balanced moment multiplied by 0.38 right here, but that balanced is negative. Or where, whichever is the smaller value here, use the sign of that. So that is simple way. So unbalanced is positive, therefore balanced is negative, and balanced moment multiplied by 0.62, so you'll get 1.116 here and 0.684 here. So better you take up to 3 or 4 digits you take, but final moments you take up to 2 digits, but here you can take up to 3 digits. And if you want to write down the steps, so see, the first step is fixed end moment. I will write down here fixed end moments. And second is balancing. This is called balancing of joint. So, or distribution. Distribution of moment or balancing of joint. Then you mark a horizontal line below this. After completing, this completes one cycle. And then carryover. Now carryover theorem. So we are using these two theorems only. Balancing carryover, which, so that's all. Only two theorem or distribution theorem. So here balancing means distribution. Distribution theorem and balancing carryover theorem. These two theorems are to be used. So now carryover. What is carryover to the next support by half value with same sign? This is plus plus. 1.29 divided by 2. Half with same sign. Plus plus. And this is 0.645. Then this is to be carried over to the next support here, plus plus 1.71 divided by 2, and this value is 0.8555. Then this divided by 2 carried over to the next support, minus, you can show this arrows, carry over arrows. So minus 1.116, this is to be carried over to the next support by half value with same sign, minus minus, so half of that is 0.558. So this is 0.558. Then this is to be carried over to its next support by half value with same sign, minus minus, and this is 0.342. This step is called carryover. So only two steps, repeats, only two steps. So developing, preparing this table is also a simple. This is carryover, next is balancing. Next is balancing. Similarly here, so only one value we have, that is the unbalanced moment. So we have to now balance. If unbalanced is minus, balanced will be plus plus. So this value multiplied by 0.43, so you write here, so this will be 0.239. this value multiplied by 0.57, you write here 0.318. Now this is plus, so balance will be minus minus. So you have to balance this joint. So 0.855 into 0.62, so this is minus 0.530, and this is minus 324. Minus 324. So balance. Now, so slowly we'll find that this unbalanced moment gets reduced or vanishes till it becomes a zero. But what happens if the values are very, very small, say point not something, then final moments which will not affect much, and we have to stop when the values unbalanced moment becomes point not something, then we will stop. So you will come to know when to stop. So generally 3-4 cycles are sufficient. Now again you mark a line. So you mark line here and carry over. Carry over with same sign, half value to the further end, provided further end is fixed or continuous. So plus, so its half value is 0.119. Now this is to be carried over here, minus 0.265. Now this is to be carried over here, this is plus 0.159. Half of this carried over, half with same sign. And this is to be carried over to the next support by half value, and this is 0.162. And again, next step is balancing. Now you might have been understood that only one value, this is negative, balancing will be positive, positive. Here positive, balancing will be negative, negative. This is to be multiplied by distribution factor right here. This is to be multiplied by this distribution factor right here. And these values comes out to be, so this is 0.113, this is 0.151, and this side 0.098 and 0.060. So again, next step is mark a, after balancing you mark line and then carry over. Then carry over. So carry over to next support by half value with same sign, positive, positive. And here it is 0.565, here point minus minus 0.049, and this is 0.0755. And here it is minus 0.03. So this is carry over. Now again balance. Balance. Now you will find that the values are very small now. It is in point not. Now we can stop. But while stopping, you balance and then stop. Balance and stop. So because further cycles will not affect our final answers much. So this balancing, this is minus, plus plus, this is plus, minus, minus, and this is 0.021. 0.027, then 0.046, and 0.023. So now we will stop here. If we carry more cycles, so you will get more and more exact results. But now the results are very close to our exact answer. Now we can stop here, because the values are in point not something. Now here we will write down final moments. This gives us final moments. So final moments, how to get the final moments now? You take the sum of all values under each of the supports. So this minus 6 plus plus plus, you take the summation considering their sign, and here you get the minus 5.0 18 or 179 you can write down, 179, or even if you write down 5.18, that is also okay. So up to two digits, better way you take. This is plus 7.66, this is minus 7.66 or 67, just check it. 8.3 positive you will get here, and minus 8.3 you will get here, and 4.26 positive you will get here. So these are the final moments. Directly we are getting final moments at the supports. Means what moments we have got here is minus, means anti-clockwise. This value we got is 5.179. Now here don't write minus, because since it is minus we have taken anti-clockwise. So now this is plus means clockwise, minus means anti-clockwise, and this value you will find the equivalent opposite, 7.66. even though if there is a small, very small difference is there between these two values, take equal. So this plus means clockwise is 8.30, and this is plus means clockwise, 4.26. So knowing this and values, now we can construct bending moment diagram. And if you want to construct SFD, so now you can find out RA, we can find out RB, RC and RD. So these reactions we can calculate by using equilibrium conditions. That means if we take moment about B considering left hand side, you will get RA. Take moment about C considering left hand side, you will get RB. Take again moment at C taking right hand side, you will get RD. And the last reaction RC is calculated by taking summation of all forces Fy. Summation Fy equal to 0, you will get RC. So calculating all this, you can construct SFD also. Now let's complete the bending moment diagram for this. So bending moment diagram directly you can complete here also, below the table we have a sufficient space. Or you draw beam once again and then you draw bending moment diagram. So let's draw BMD. Now first you draw BMD due to the loading, that is called free BMD, WL by 4, or simply supported beam is WL by 4, 4 gets cancelled, means 12. So you will get BMD like this. So the bending moment here is 12. Then for UDL it is WL square by 8. So W is 3, L square 36 divided by 8. This value you have to calculate, and the I think this is 13.5, so slightly greater than this. So this value is 13.5. Then this is WAB by L. For simply supported, W is 10, A is 2, 3 divided by 5. So 12, this is 12 now. So this is 12. So this is called free BMD or bending moment diagram due to the this. Now this is negative anti-clockwise, means the all arrows are downward. So draw ordinate upward or on tension side. This is 5.7, slightly greater than this. Then 8, again slightly greater than this. And 4 less. So diagram due to end moment, this is 5.179, this is 7.66, this is 8.30, and this is 4.26. So this gives us BMD. The final BMD is indicated by the shaded area